Hi everyone, this is Balázs from RacingBrick. Today we are taking a spoiler-free deep dive into one of the most interesting LEGO mechanisms I've seen in a long time, the transformation system inside the LEGO Icons 11370, the Creel House. Don't worry, this video is completely safe if you haven't watched Stranger Things Season 5 yet. I watched Season 4 when it aired, and I won't start Season 5 until the final episode is available, so I'm keeping this spoiler-free for myself as well. This video focuses only on the mechanical engineering inside the set. No story details from the manual, no minifigures, no stickers applied, I'm keeping this as clean as possible. Alright, let's talk about the mechanism, because this is where the set becomes something truly special. Honestly, it's more exciting than some Transformer sets. Inside this beautifully detailed, but slightly creepy house, the designers hid a surprisingly complex multi-stage transformation system. And it all happens with one continuous motion, it's absolutely mesmerizing to watch. What makes it even more amazing is how few Technic parts are used. When you pull the two sides of the house outward, the entire structure begins a coordinated transformation. Let's see that again from the other side, because there are so many things happening. Remember, this is a fully furnished house with tons of detail that we will intentionally ignore for now. So let's break down what is happening here. As you see, there are three major sections of the building, a central core, and two side assemblies. The side sections slide on double rails built into the foundation. One of these rails is even built sideways. It's a snug fit, sliding smoothly on tiles, all color-coded for easier identification. The sideways built rail ends with these rounded parts, and those pieces push or release the hinged Technic lift arms. Those lift arms connect to the long brown links, and the other end of each link connects to the tops of the trees. Because the lift arms are hinged, once you pull the sides apart, the lift arms no longer hold their horizontal position, and the weight of the treetops naturally folds them down on both sides. It's extremely clever. Now let's see the building sections. Let's start with the right side, looking from the back. This is the simpler action, relatively speaking. There's a shorter link here attached with toboggans. When the sections pull apart, that link rotates this entire room and the half roof above it. I can remove the whole assembly so you can see how it sits. There's a turntable underneath and smooth tiles around it, allowing the rotation to happen effortlessly. The link is positioned perfectly for the exact rotation range required. The left side is surprisingly static for the first side. Nothing rotates here, the only movement is this first floor wall section. You can actually see the pin from the front that holds it. In the spooky form, you can move this wall by hand, and here's what positions it during the transformation. There's an angled part here, and if we remove the front wall, you can see a similar black piece sticking out that pushes it precisely into place. This brown tile touches the front assembly, but when the front section starts rotating, the tile no longer supports the wall, so it drops. When everything closes again, the inner part pushes the wall back up and the front locks it perfectly. It's a beautiful example of micro-precision. Speaking of that front section with the entrance, you can't really see it from outside, but the front assembly actually connects to the left side. In the base, there are strategically placed wedge plates, and the front assembly has this 1x3 rounded plate underneath. When you move the sides, that rounded plate follows the wedges and guides the entire front section outward. Now about the central part, it's easier to show what doesn't move. The entrance stays still, the walls directly above it stay still, and these two small roof sections remain fixed. Practically everything else moves. There's a rotating wall in the middle, with a weird plate underneath that looks like a studded gear. On the left side, there's a long plate with jumper plates that engage this gear and rotate the wall, a very unusual interaction method. The upper section here uses probably the most complex mechanism. It involves two links and a joint commonly seen in mechs and UCS 8080s. The joint rotates, and thanks to the double linkage, the big assembly of the roof moves along a circular path to reach the endpoint at the top. If we check from the side, it is much further back than its original position. You know, I'm obsessed with mechanical LEGO creations, and this building is a masterpiece of LEGO engineering. It's no surprise Mike Psyche was heavily involved. He presented the set at Famedia Days in Billund. The synchronized movement of all these elements is pure genius. I'm sure you'll ask how solid the build is, considering it has so many moving parts. Well, I wouldn't suggest shaking it around in battle mode, although moving it might still be possible, but in this form it's actually quite stable. There's one important thing to notice. these branches on both sides are not just decoration. They have a critical structural role by being connected to the walls, and they make the trees act as practical handles. You should use these to control the motion and avoid pulling the model apart by grabbing anything else, because those parts are not designed to take the load. This wall section here is a good example. It holds for a while, but not for too long. There are a few other fairly weak points as well. The build is solid overall, but you do need to pay attention. So that was it, the mechanical wonders of the LEGO Creel House. I can't wait to watch the final season, so all the details will finally start to make sense. And of course, once we get closer to release, I will show you the two cool vehicles from the box, the gifted purchase radio station, and we will take a look at the finished Creel House together with all the minifigures. So folks, let me know if you enjoyed these deep dives into the engineering side of LEGO sets. Should LEGO make more models with built-in moving functions like this? Let's talk about it in the comments section. If you enjoyed this video, then please give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe with notifications, as more exciting LEGO videos are coming soon. See you next time, bye bye.